How many grips are in that volume?
Around 8.
For a second tournament in a row, Alex managed to pick up yet another elusive ATP point after he dismissed the 18-year-old Turk and fellow qualifier, Cemre Türk, in a relatively easy 6-2, 6-2 first round match. After Alex's victory over Türk, he guaranteed that he would shoot up almost 400 spots to at least 1674 in the ATP singles rankings, not to mention also make the hotel we were staying at least $258 wealthier. In the second round of the main draw of the Turkey F25 futures, Alex had his hands full with the 26-year-old Serb, Nikola Čačić, who is currently ranked at 481, but has been as high as 281 back in September of 2014. Čačić also happens to be a connoisseur of the game of doubles, reaching a ranking of 240 back in 2012. Overall, Čačić has accumulated 4 futures singles titles and a whopping 25 futures doubles titles. The winner of this match would walk away with at least 2 ATP points and $438.
Kadbra. Bravo. Allez, putain. Thank you. Super, sono a toccare.
Prvi servis, davaj!
Yeah.
Ka. Radka.
Bravo.
Bravo, ajde.
So when did the turkey have 25 futures for Alex in the second round of the main draw? Had he gotten his hands on that singular match point at 5-4 in the third set on Čačić's serve, he would have secured at least 2 ATP points with a chance to play for a total of 6 points in the next round. But perhaps another time, another place. Meanwhile, in the quarterfinals, Nikola Čačić went on to defeat Jamil Kell, the number 1 seed, ranked at 257, whose father happens to own the Garanti Koza World of Sports Academy. He then fell to the eventual champion,
Geoffrey Blancano,
in a 3-set war in the semifinals, where he too missed out on a match point.
Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up.